Do you think having Donald Trump as president is galvanizing for the movement, like a lot of people assume?
I absolutely think it is. In my day, in the late 80s and early 90s, it would have been absolutely unthinkable to imagine the president of the United States saying that our country is being infested by people who are crossing our borders illegally and likening them to vermin. That was how we talk. And we, back in the late 80s, early 90s, like, Pat Buchanan was about the farthest right that you got. And we didn't, well, he would get kind of xenophobic, but he was just kind of a minor player. He wasn't,
right.
You know, he was a pundit, he's a former politician, whatever. He didn't have that much influence. Like, your run-of-the-mill GOP in the late 80s, early 90s were very much more, you know, George Bush, Reagan kind of thing, where you could certainly argue there was some racist undertones to their beliefs and their policies and their actions. There was nothing like overtly racist about it. And that pissed us off. We were like, you know, fuck them. They're as bad as the liberals. They don't care about the white race. Nowadays, every single person that I've helped to leave hate groups in the past 10 years from 2016 on was like, before they left, they were huge cheerleaders of Donald Trump. And there were Klan groups who put up like robocall campaigns for him. So, you know, it doesn't matter that his son-in-law is Jewish. It doesn't matter how many black church leaders he gathers in the Oval Office from time to time. I don't honestly think that personally Donald Trump is like an avowed, I think he'll just say whatever gets him phrased. I think that's what motivates him. I don't think race motivates him. But at the same time, what he says to get praise really resounds with racists.
I recently read a book about Facebook and went pretty deep into the election. And basically what it was showing was he was just testing different phrases, different sayings in all these different groups. And so whether you were white, of this income, and different target demographics. And what he was realizing, he could literally like pick posts by cities and see which ones are being reshared a lot. And on Facebook, that's what you want. The more it gets shared, the more likes, the more it propagates, the bigger circle seeing it. And the strategy meetings he would have were not around, okay, you know, Mr. Trump, what are your policies? It was like, what is working? And then he would just lean into that.
Yep.
And which, good and bad, right? Good if you want to win. Bad if you're propagating a message that doesn't necessarily inspire or lead or move the country or civilization into, it just gets you elected, but it doesn't mean you're doing good by anybody.
No, exactly. I think it's certainly a win at all costs approach.
Yeah.
And I think a big factor of that is his advisor, Stephen Miller. Who is like an outright white nationalist. And the first thing anybody on the right's going to say, Tucker Carlson would be like, he's Jewish. How can a Jew be a white nationalist? Very easily. Back in my day, there were a number of guys who, like, after the fact, we find out they're Jewish after they had joined our group and been in it for months. And they were violently expelled. But it was not uncommon for Jews, for people of color. I even had, in the early days, like before I went like full-blown white power, there was a black skinhead who hung out with us, and he had a collection of black people jokes. He would like rip on black women. He was like very much like self-loathing black person. So this idea of like, well, he's Jewish, how can he be a white nationalist? No, that doesn't stop you whatsoever. It doesn't mean that you can't be that when your policies are outright white nationalism.
Hey everyone, thanks for checking out that clip. If you enjoyed it, be sure to hit the like button down below. And if you're interested in hearing the full episode, it's out right now on our YouTube channel. We've had a lot of great guests come on this show before, and we've got a lot of great guests coming up in the future. So hit subscribe so that you don't miss a single episode. And one final note, we're always looking for new ideas and new companies to feature on the show. So if you know of someone or know of a company, write us a comment down below letting us know who they are and what they do. We'd be happy to have them on the show. Till then, I'll just be here waiting for your comments. So see you later.